exercise we do here that works very good, and I like it, is called a garage pull. And you'll see a lot of that in Spanish typewriting. And this is, I'm told, how the medieval knights would school their horses to ride. But it's a very good exercise for you to learn how to guide your horse with your seat and your legs. So when I go like this, you see how my waist twists? I look where I'm going, my legs twist, see my stick, how it turns? So that's kind of how you're going to guide this horse around, with that action like that. So if I'd guide my horse with just my hands, mechanically, I can't do this circle with the garage pull. It'll tell on you. And so we're going to work on doing this with our seat and our pelvis and the motion of our body. So what we'll do is we're going to insert some footage of finished horses that are doing the garage pull in a canter. But this horse right here, for the sake of demonstration, has never done the garage pull. But I wanted to do that on purpose for you to see how to prepare your horse to do that, because what I don't want to have happen is somebody out there somewhere see us do this and go get them a pole and get themselves hurt because they didn't prepare themselves properly. So I don't know what's going to happen here, but I've got a good feeling everything's going to work out all right because this horse has been prepared properly. Okay, and his mind has been conditioned to learn. So this is raw footage, and we're just going to show you what we go through to get this started, okay? So the first thing is that this pole is a piece of 13-foot long PVC pipe. Just go over to the plumbing store, cut you off a piece 13 feet long. And if it's too long to fit in your car or whatever, cut it in half. And you can get a coupling and glue it together when you get home, or you can get a fitting that's a male on one side, female on another, and just screw it together and have it where you can take it apart in two pieces and transport it. But it's got to be 13 feet, because if it's longer than that, it's too long, and if it's much shorter than that, it's just too short. But our ultimate goal is to be able to canter this circle around this pole and keep it in the same hole in the middle. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to see how this horse reacts to the pipe above his head. Okay, so go ahead, Daniel, and you can wave it. All right, hand me the pole. So what I'll do sometimes is we'll come like this and we'll walk around him like this. And we'll come around back of him with it. And then I'll take the pole like this. I don't know if you can hear it, but you hear that dragging on the ground. Oh, buddy, some horses don't like that, okay? So I'm gonna come like this. And I'm gonna simulate how he's gonna do it mounted, okay? I'm gonna do it in both directions. And if you'll notice, every time I ever do something, I don't even think about it, but I always do it in both directions. Because if I only did it one way, well, as luck would have it, you'll go do it the other way and it'll be just like you're starting over again, okay? So now I'm gonna drop it on the ground and I'm gonna let him walk over it. And it's okay if he hits it. He got to be okay with this thing. You know, part of getting horses ready is getting them to where they're comfortable with your tools. But see, that all started a long time ago. I got him to where he was comfortable with this stick first, okay? He's not afraid of the flag and he's not afraid of the stick. Okay, go ahead. Now stop. Back up. Okay, so at this stage in the game, if you feel any resistance or fear, stop and resolve it. He's got to learn to manage his fear. Don't go a step further until you can do what we just did, okay? And if you do, do it at your own risk, please. Okay. Now, Daniel, take it and drag it beside you, and let's go around the pen dragging it. Now, if your horse were to act up, drop the pole. Just drop it. We're going to try not to make this an episode. We don't want a catastrophe. We don't want him to have any bad experiences or memories about this. Now, bring it over top of your head, Daniel, and come on the other side with it. Can you do that? There you go. Oop, go ahead. There you go. But see how he's dropped one hand, he holds the pole with one hand and his reins with the other. So this is a good way for a rider to learn to ride one-handed. You've got to use your legs and seat, or you can't guide your horse, there's no doubt about it. All right. All right, now turn your horse up under the pole and go the other direction. Now, I want you to turn and bring his head underneath the pole when you turn, okay? There you go. Just like that. Perfect. Perfect. So you might have to do this for a little while, half hour or whatever. Just get him feeling real good about it. And I'll tell you another thing you can do is if you got other people riding with you in horses, get them to follow behind you. So as he's dragging that pole, you get your other rider to walk right beside it and get that horse feeling real good about that pole. I've got friends that can do this bridleless. I mean, this is very, very high-class riding. I mean, this is the difference between a high-class and a low-class horse right here. All right, now, Daniel, what I want you to do is come to the center of the pen and ride around your pole like we do. Okay. Okay. Now, there's some things I want to point out here that you got to take note of. When he's going around, you see how he's looking? Daniel's looking with his chin, and he's pointing with his chin toward the center, and he's looking toward that center point. And he's guiding that horse with his seat and his legs. Okay? And see his body posture? That's proper, right there. You can't get any better than that, right there. Okay? Now, you notice how that pole is staying right in the center. It's not moving. He's got his horse prepared properly. And I tell you, I think this is a good reflection on everybody that works here at Windy Hill Farm. Daniel never rode this horse before 15, 20 minutes ago. Okay? The point is, if everybody does everything the same and you have consistent standards, look what you end up with. A man can get on a horse and ride him around and never rode him before and do that 15 minutes. Consistency, name of the game. All right, now, Daniel, I want you to try to do that circle, but look straight ahead when you're doing it. Like, look. See how his circle gets junky and the horse starts dribbling? Things don't look right. All right, now look to the center and do it. See how that horse immediately bent and is going in the circle properly. That right there is probably one of the number one things that I spend my days working on here is telling people, look where you're going. Take your chin and point where you're going. Look where you're going. You can't guide your horse unless you know where you're going first. You got to look where you're going. Well, the Calvary Manual says that you're to look forward 15 feet. So if you're riding along, you're looking ahead of where you're going. Okay, now, Daniel, turn and go the other direction, will you please? See how he takes his leg, moves the horse's shoulder, okay? But that was all started. Remember my video on how to side pass your horse where I got the stick and moved the horse around and you used your spur to reinforce your leg? Well, that's why we do all that. Okay? So a guy can get on this horse that never rode him before and take that horse and move him around without having to pound on him to do it. So see how he's using his spur? That's okay. But the horse isn't flinching. He's not afraid of it. He's responding to it. He's using it to guide his horse. Okay? See? He's using that spur to guide his horse. All right, now stop. Walk. There you go. Now, Daniel, let's try to just trot, okay? Now, after Daniel trots this circle, I think it's too early for him to try to canter it. We'll try it and see what happens. But we'll insert some footage here of horses that are cantering, that are finished horses that are very nice doing the garage pole. And I got to tell you, folks, if you can canter this circle with that pole, you're an operator. So that's how you get started doing this, and in our next video we'll try to canter it and see if we can take it to the next level.